Support us today, Odisha's fastest growing web news channel.
Hello and a very good evening. Welcome you all to News at 7 on Reporters Today with me, Nidhi, and these are the headlines. Meeting held to make new empowered Odisha. Day 7, STFO continued their protest without caring about their health. State executive meeting kicks off today. Bijapur MLA Subal Sahu passes away. Mission 11 billion initiative launched to promote football among children. Now the news in details. The Odisha government has stretched its leg towards its preparedness in handling of the super cyclone. The state had made international headline for its unpreparedness in handling of a super cyclone. Through sheer teamwork, commitment and our pro-people policy, we have come a long way in the last 17 years. We can look into the eye of the storm and have set global benchmark in disaster management, said CM Naveen Patnaik in a video conference at State Secretariat here on today. CM focused on 3T. 3T means transparency, teamwork and technology. CM Naveen Patnaik, Chief Secretary Aditya Prasad Padi and DGP KB Singh was present there in the meeting.
We have come a long way from 2000. We are in the transition towards forming a new empowered Odisha. I have full faith that Team Odisha will transform Odisha utilizing the 3 T's of technology, transparency and teamwork.
Despite of the continuous demonstration by block grant teachers and employees belonging to the School and College Teachers Federation of Odisha STFO and Lecturer Association, no steps were taken yet. Earlier teachers were in hope, but after the return of the CM, teachers totally lost their hope on CM in relation to their demand. Teachers were in the protest without caring their health, and according to the latest update, a lady teacher felt unconscious during the demonstration here on today. The state BJP executive meeting was held today at Hotel Marion in the capital city. The meeting focuses on the weak points of the BJD so that they can pressurize the BJD government. The Saffron Party also chalked out the strategies for forthcoming 2019 general election. Among others, Union Minister Dharmendra Pradhan, Joel Oram and the Chief Guest Narendra Singh Tomar inaugurated the meeting.
आज भारतीय जनता पार्टी उड़ीसा राज्य की कार्य समिति का पहला दिन है और मैं इस कार्य समिति में भाग लेने के लिए आया था। उड़ीसा राज्य में भारतीय जनता पार्टी बहुत तेजी के साथ आगे बढ़ रही है। पिछले दिनों पंचायती राज संस्थाओं के जो चुनाव हुए उसमें उड़ीसा की जनता का बहुत आशीर्वाद भारतीय जनता पार्टी को मिला। इसके लिए मैं जनता का आभार प्रकट करता हूं और कार्यकर्ताओं को बहुत बहुत बधाई देना चाहता हूं।
पुलिस सीज्ड ह्यूज अमाउंट ऑफ फॉर्मल्डिहाइड व्हिच वाज बीइंग स्मगल्ड इन एन ऑटो रिक्शा यस्टरडे। द केमिकल वाज बीइंग ट्रांसपोर्टेड फॉर प्रोसेसिंग ड्राई फिश इन द लोकेलिटी। एक्टिंग ऑन अ टिप ऑफ पारादीप पुलिस मेज द सीज्ड एक्शन। Some traders were allegedly procuring the chemical to process dry fish. Since use of formaldehyde in dry fish processing poses health hazard, the fishery department has clamped prohibitory order on use of any form of the chemical. Despite the restriction, some traders and processors have been allegedly using the chemical for the preservation of dry fish. Earlier, the department had issued notices to various dry fish manufacturing units, Marine Fisherman Bodies, Trawl Operators Association, beside Fisherman Cooperative Society to refrain from using the preservative. However, the use of chemical continues unabated in the region. Said sources, locals alleged that a racket is operating to supply toxic substance to local dry fish traders. Further investigation is on. BJD Cooperative Call meeting held at State Secretariat Office here on today. MLA Ranendra Pratap Swain was presided this meeting. The next cooperative election will be held in 2020. The ruling BJD has captured 95% of the cooperative president post in the state, clamped MLA R. Pratap Swain. Odisha is the first state to implement RuPay debit card. As many as 2,709 cooperative societies were computerized and all the databases are created for farmers in the state. CM Naveen Patnaik and Minister Surya Narayan Patra also graced the occasion. BJD demands to remove the 18% GST on handloom and textiles.
We are just having meetings of our state cooperative bodies. I have told them to work hard for the people, particularly for the farmers.
Our Rajyare Pratham Thara Pai 90 Bhagra Adhika Sambhaya Sanstare Biju Janata Dal Samarthita Sahapati Sampadak Gaurav Director Member Mane Jitikiri Aschanti ଏବଂ ସେମାନଙ୍କର ମୁଖିଆମାନଙ୍କର ଆଜି ଏକ ୱାର୍କସପ୍ ହୋଇଥିଲା ସମବାୟ ଆନ୍ଦୋଳନର କଥାକୁ ହାତରେ ଧରି ଲୋକମାନଙ୍କୁ ସାଧାରଣ ଲୋକଙ୍କୁ ସେଥିରେ କିପରି ଇନଭଲ୍ଭ କରାହୋଇପାରିବ ଆଉ ତା'ର ଫାଇଦା ସେମାନେ କେମିତି ନେଇପାରିବେ ସେହି ବିଷୟରେ ଆଲୋଚନା ହୋଇଥିଲା ଏବଂ ମୁଖ୍ୟତଃ ଆମର ଚାଷୀମାନଙ୍କ ପାଇଁ ଯେଉଁ ସମବାୟ ବିଭାଗର 2000 ପ୍ରାଇମେରୀ ସୋସାଇଟି ଅଛି ସେହି ସୋସାଇଟି ଗୁଡ଼ିକରେ ଚାଷୀମାନେ ଯେଉଁମାନେ ଜମି ଅଛି କିମ୍ବା ଅନ୍ୟର ଜମି ଚାଷ କରୁଛନ୍ତି ସେମାନେ କେମିତି ରେଜିଷ୍ଟ୍ରେସନ୍ କରିପାରିବେ ସମସ୍ତ ସୁବିଧା ସୁଯୋଗ ପାଇପାରିବେ ତା ପାଇଁ ସମସ୍ତ ସମବାୟ ଚେଷ୍ଟା କରିବା ଦରକାର ଏବଂ ସମବାୟ ବିଭାଗର ଯେଉଁ ସବୁ ଅସୁବିଧା ଅଛି ସେ ଅସୁବିଧାକୁ ସମାଧାନ କରାଯିବ ସେଥିରେ କୌଣସି ଭୟ କରିବାର କାରଣ ନାହିଁ ଏ କଥା କୁହାଯାଇଛି
Congress MLA Subal Sahu from Bijapur constituency died while undergoing treatment at the private hospital here today. He was 57. His nephew informed about his demise. Cancer strike in Sahu was suffering from fever from last 3 days, he added. Chief Minister Naveen Patnaik, Leader of Opposition Narasimha Mishra, Union Minister Dharmendra Pradhan, BJD MP Bejinta Panda and other leaders condoled the death of legislator.
ଦୁର୍ଭାଗ୍ୟବଶତଃ ଆଜି ସେ ତାଙ୍କର ଦେହାନ୍ତ ହୋଇଗଲା ମୁଁ ସେଥିପାଇଁ ଦୁଃଖ ପ୍ରକାଶ କରୁଛି
ଏବଂ ତାଙ୍କର ଯେଉଁ ବ୍ୟବହାର ଚାଲିଚଳନ ସାଧାରଣ ଲୋକଙ୍କ ସହ ଯେଉଁ ତାଙ୍କର ସାଂଗଠନିକ ଦକ୍ଷତା ଥିଲା ମିଶିବା ଏବଂ ନିରବଚ୍ଛିନ୍ନ ହିସାବରେ ଲୋକଙ୍କ ସେବା କରିବା ପାଇଁ ଯେଉଁ ପ୍ରୟାସ ସେ ଚଳାଇଥିଲେ ବିଜେପୁର ନିର୍ବାଚନ ମଣ୍ଡଳୀ ବିକାଶ ପାଇଁ ଯଦିଓ ସେ କଂଗ୍ରେସ ଦଳର ସଦସ୍ୟ ଥିଲେ ତାର ସତ୍ତ୍ୱେ ସେ ଅନ୍ୟ ଦଳ ବିଜୁ ଜନତା ଦଳ କିମ୍ବା ଭାରତୀୟ ଜନତା ପାର୍ଟିର ଅନ୍ୟ ନେତାମାନଙ୍କ ସହ ମଧ୍ୟ ତାଙ୍କର ଘନିଷ୍ଠ ସମ୍ପର୍କ ଥିଲା ମୋ ସହ ବି ତାଙ୍କର ଘନିଷ୍ଠ ବନ୍ଧୁତ୍ୱ ଥିଲା ମୁଁ ତାଙ୍କର ଦେହାନ୍ତରେ ଗଭୀର ମର୍ମାହତ ବ୍ୟକ୍ତ କରୁଛି ଶୋକ କରୁଛି ଏବଂ ତାଙ୍କର ଅମର ଆତ୍ମାର ଶାନ୍ତି ପାଇଁ ଭଗବାନଙ୍କଠାରେ ପ୍ରାର୍ଥନା କରୁଛି
Protesting consolidation of banks, loan defaults by large borrowers and inadequate capital support, bank union observe a nationwide strike today. The strike had been called by the United Forum of Bank Union, UFBU, an umbrella body of 9 unions including the All India Bank Officer Confederation, AIBOC and the All India Bank Employees Association, AIBEA. We are against consolidation of public sector banks and have placed a 16-point charter of demands before the government, which wants to reduce the number of public sector banks in the country to around 10 through a series of mergers and acquisitions, said a bank official. In what may turn out to be a landmark verdict, the Supreme Court pronounced a historic judgment on the controversial issue of whether the practice of triple talaq among Muslims is fundamental to the religion. A 5-judge constitution bench headed by Chief Justice J.S. Kehar had reserved its verdict on May 18 after a 6-day marathon hearing during the summer vacation. The Supreme Court, by a majority verdict, today declared the triple talaq was void and illegal.
ଆମର ଭାରତୀୟ ସମ୍ବିଧାନ ଅନୁସାରେ ଯେଉଁ ନିୟମ ଯେଉଁ ପାଳନ ଇଏ ନିଷ୍ପତ୍ତି ନିଆଯାଇଛି ଏହା ଆମ ସମସ୍ତଙ୍କୁ ମାନିବାର କଥା ଆମର ସମାଜର ମୁସଲିମ ସମୁଦାୟର ସମସ୍ତଙ୍କୁ ମାନିବାର କଥା ଆଉ ମୁଁ ସ୍ୱାଗତ କରୁଛି ଆଜ୍ ଏ ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ପ୍ରେସିଡେଣ୍ଟ ହିସାବରେ ମାଇନୋରିଟି ମୋର୍ଚ୍ଚାର ଇଏ ଭଲ ନିଷ୍ପତ୍ତି ନିଆଯାଇଛି
The government is taking up an ambitious program to promote football among children in the country. Mission 11 billion has been initiated to take football to 11 billion children across India. Viva Junior 17 World Cup is being organized in partnership with the All India Football Federation and in order to create football culture, Mission 11 billion has been initiated where through 15,000 schools and mass contact programs the mission would be accomplished. The Mission 11 Billion, a football initiative aimed towards taking the game to 15,000 schools in 37 cities across the country, was same like set rolling in Odisha Kalinga Stadium in presence of Sports Minister Chandra Sarthi Behra, Sports Secretary Vishal Dev, football player Sridhanjali Samantre. According to the source, total of 32 teams will participate in, and for better performance of the state, school level practices in high. In this event, the official mascot of the Under-17 World Cup was also present there, named Khelio. The FIFA Under-17 World Cup will be held in October this year, according to the sports minister, will ensure that the India becomes a bright spot in world football.
जमी कि मुझे फुटबॉल इट्स सेल्फ बहुत पॉपुलर गेम गोटे ओडिशा रे माने वर्ल्ड रे भी पॉपुलर एवं ओडिशा रे मध्य काफी फैन रही फुटबॉल रो एवं आपन जमी जानी जूनियर वर्ल्ड कप अक्टोबर रे इंडिया रे हवापाई जाऊँ तो फुटबॉल रे पिलांकर आहुरी इंटरेस्ट बढ़ावापी कि गोटे छोट एटा गोटे चेष्टा प्रचेषा यहाँ चली आशा करूँ ए पाकर आहरी आग्रह बढ़ खेल प्रति
निश्चित भाव AFF वर्ल्ड इंडिया फुटबॉल फेडरेशन आमर गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया और फिफा तरफ जो आम मिशन 11 मिलियन फेस्टिवल होमर भुवनेश्वर से यूर आम स्कूल लेवल रे फुटबॉल को कमी प्रमोट कराव ये कमी यंग टैलेंट मैंने आसवे अवेयरनेस प्रोग्राम यहाँ गोटे यादारा आम यंग टैलेंट मैंने फ्यूचर में आम कंट्री पर रिप्रेजेंट करेंगे जोटा को आगू आम Under-17 वर्ल्ड कप अच्छी ताकू आखि आगे रखिक यू प्रोग्राम करादारा आम जो टैलेंट मैंने बाहर से आगू को फ्यूचर में इंडिया पार्टिसिपेट करेंगे.
Thank you for the time. These are the news. To be updated with the news, log on to www.reporterstoday.com and download the app.